Hi everyone. This video demonstrates how to enable the endpoint mode on AM57 platforms using Processor Software Development Kit, also known as the Processor SDK. Starting from SDK 3.2 release, PCIe endpoint mode is supported on selective devices. The AM57X platforms are the first to be supported for PCIe endpoint mode, and we'll show you how that is done in this video. We will start by identifying the required hardware and how to set up the demonstrations. Then we will discuss what software is required, how to configure the kernel to be in endpoint mode, and finally, how to run the basic test to verify the functionality of PCIe endpoint mode. Now here we displayed the required hardware, including a PCIe bus extender. Then we have AM572X IDK on the left, the mini PCIe to PCIe adapter, and finally the AM572 GP EVM. Because different EVMs has different PCIe connectors, the IDK has a standard PCIe connector, but the AM57 GP EVM has a mini PCIe connector, so we need an adapter to convert it. So first we plug in the adapter to the PCIe port of the GP EVM, then connect the both EVM with the bus extenders. ProSDK is released with the PCIe default as the root complex. To run the endpoint mode, we need to download the kernel, the release package, modify the kernel configurations, and rebuild it as an endpoint mode. The ProSDK can be installed by running the installer. There are more detailed information in the Get Started Guide and the Kernel Users Guide. On the Linux machine, I have pre-downloaded and installed the Linux ProSDK 3.2 release, and I set up the cross-compiler path. Then we need to configure the kernel as the TI-SDK AM57XX EVM default configurations. Then run the menu config to enable the endpoint mode. In the menu config, we go to the bus support, PCI endpoint, then select the PCI endpoint support, and also the PCI endpoint test drive. Then we get out of it, then go to PCI controller drivers, then go into PCIe mode, and select endpoint only mode. Exit the menu config and save the change. Then we need to modify the device tree by disabling the root complex node and enabling the endpoint. Then save the change of the device tree. Then we can build the kernel image and the device tree, then copy them to the SD card of the endpoint side. To copy to the SD card, we need to mount the SD card as a type ext3. It will be under the boot directory. Copy the both the kernel image and the device tree under it. Then mount the SD card. That's it. On the root complex side, we need to build the PCI test executables. The source code is under tools PCI directory, and we can cross-compile it. Then copy that, the same method, to the root complex SD card. Then all the SD card image are ready to be tested. In the two EVM connection scenarios, the endpoint EVM need to come up first. So once it come up, then we have to use sysfs to configure the endpoint mode. There's some more details in the PCIe endpoint users guide. In the kernel users guide, there's a link to it. First, you need to configure the function device instance. Then bind it to a function driver, which can be found using the ls commands at the directory of sysbus pci-epf-drivers. That will list the function drivers. Then we need to bind the function driver to the controller driver. When you bind the controller drivers, you will see some errors saying the buffer4 and buffer5 are not available. There's some bad addresses. That's due to the non-availability of free inbound windows. So the function drivers in DRH7 can use only 4 bars. That is from bar 0 to bar 3. Once we bind this, then the endpoint is ready. Then we can bring up the root complex EVM. When root complex kernel boots up, we have the PCI test executable copied earlier to the file system. And we can create a script file to run different tests. Here's the examples that we use to test the base address registers, the interrupts, the read, write, and copy operations, and run it. PCI endpoint is functional. Thank you for taking the time to watch this demonstrations. Additional information are provided here for references. If you have any questions, please post them on the Texas Instruments E2E forum at e2e.ti.com.